Have you ever wanted a facehugger in your home, but had no way to keep it safely contained? I have your solution, the Facehugger Stasis Tube. This life-sized work of art measures 12 inches in diameter at its widest, with a total height of 37 inches tall. I'll be guiding you through the cleaning phases, painting, detailing, and final assembly. On the way, I'll review the steps required to produce a custom electronic base for your display. You can find a link to view the kit components in greater detail in this window. Let's get started on this beast. If you have wooden mount plates, you'll need to prime them in an MDF sealer. The best brand I've found is called Kills Primer, available at most Home Depot stores. The styrene strips can be replaced with aluminum sheet strips, but here we're using styrene. To create the top mount, you'll attach the inner ring to the outer ring. And then attach the top mount plate centered on this entire assembly. Paint the resin cast nuts and attach onto the fiberglass rods. You can also substitute aluminum rods for these parts. Now, take the clear acrylic bottom plate and trim the diffusion material that will be glued onto one side. Here's your finished bottom section. Just like we did earlier, wrap these bands around the top and bottom of the clear tube. Be sure to mount the top band so that it is flush to the top rod mount position. And there you have it. Here's the finished components ready to stack. You can leave your stasis tube as is. But let me show you how to illuminate it to really bring it to life. To create the light up feature, you can hack an LED light from Home Depot. Here, we're using a piece of PVC to create the mount. Click on these links to check out the Colonial Marine Armor and Alien Queen. Thanks for watching.